Welcome back all. I just made a video for you that proved I could make 5,000 income for workers. Let's continue. So in the last video you could see we had a 5,000 income with just workers everywhere. And now we will start upgrading into artisans. Let's go. First I will create some more farmer workforce. And then some more normal workers. And then I probably do not have enough steel to upgrade a lot of guys. You see, so maybe let's get some steel first. See, fish is already is almost tanking. Yeah, but we're upgrading out of fish also. Yeah, we will be okay. Well, now automate my steel buys. There we go, since I'm not producing steel anywhere. Some lag with loading the region, and it's still loading the region. So here I have now two coal mines. And I also have one iron deposit here. Which I will import from the furnace to my island over here, where I will make sewing machines from that. The only problem is we do not have windows yet. Let's plan my sewing machines. There we go. I don't build them up yet, but they're planned. So, we need windows. Doesn't fit. Then like this, is there? Yeah, okay. Remember that there is a bonus for maintenance costs. You get minus 10% if you invest 300. So that's why I chose to upgrade an empty one over here. Oh, with artisans now in town. Oh, they get rum. Ah, okay, they get rum. Yeah, from a festival. and there my first sewing machines go up. And over here I have these guys. See, they're still booting up. So here now I have everyone with a plus A1 if they have a school, and here I save on the consumption of snaps. three sewing machines nicely now. Nicely filling up, I mean. Add a bigger ship to have less traffic on the same pier. There we go. I've not been to the new world yet, so I now start buying rum locally. So this gives some nice income and some happiness, so that's nice. You see, slowly we get the first beef and red peppers in. And now we're producing the first goulash, and from there the first canned food. Ah, the first rum is in, isn't that nice? So you see here a guy for soap making. And a guy for clay pits with less workforce. And a guy for coal mine, charcoal kiln. See, it costs 7 coins to make soap, like almost nothing. Nice positive newspaper. You see, it has everything. Steelworks, iron mine, coal mine, charcoal kiln and furnace. Ha! That was what I was aiming for. I get a maintenance minus 10% now. Because I built all the trade unions and other items. And there we go, another maintenance cost guy, minus 30%. Could have brought some cannons, I forgot. I could have brought some steel. I don't get it. If the normal output is 1, then 200% should be 2, not? So it should be 8. Oh, the output is 2. but if the output is 2. Oh, the output is not even 2, because we're still overproducing. I have no idea what's going on. I don't want to understand. So now I have a guy with extra income. Notice I get 3 fisheries here now. See, the cost is 0. Just with some very basic guys, and we get extra tallow, so welcome extra tallow. Over here we use tallow, so that's good. some extra production over here. So we have a brick factory, maintenance cost minus 100. So we have free maintenance, free brick factories here. Isn't that nice? You see, now I have 20% less workforce on canneries. That's nice. So here I have a guy that's good for electricity, but I have no engineers yet. Isn't that nice? You see, all these guys have electricity now, so I can shut down half of them. And I'm still doing okay, but it saves a lot of money. Really annoyed that I have to wait on Windows a very long time. Thank you. See, maintenance cost minus 80. Isn't that nice? You see, only 20. And here, workforce needed minus 40%. Isn't that nice? Dump this one and use it for bakeries instead. You see, I'm still optimizing with very small items, very simple items. Let's see, I add here a residence plus 10. There we go. This guy, plus 20% productivity for all of them. Isn't that nice? So you have no extra cost of upgrading earlier. We need a few workers. Here's the first one where bread is slowly rolling back. So we could use some more bread for export reasons. See, they're all in range of the bread guy, so that should be okay. We're making a nice income over here now. And there, now we also have two piers here. Everyone has good piers. Here now we'll boost, the maintenance cost bonus for the weapon factories. Very nice. Ah, we had a steelwork guy in already. And what was this? Wait, for mines. I think that guy can better go here. Yep. Soap was a little under, bread was under, but is now good again. We could use a little bit more beer. So beer is going good now, and I was wondering why rain wasn't picking up. That was because I needed the guy in between first. Here I now have extra productivity, very nice. How's bread doing? Bread restored. Not very hard yet, but it restored. See, everything is in. I need a second ship because of the distance. Tea for coach is going up, rum is going up. We have no snaps here. Oh. We demolished the road connection or something? Yeah. I already missed a lot of income. I was like, where's the income gone to? So it's always a good idea to check your markers if everything is keeping up. And it is. I'm only not really satisfied with bread at the moment. Maybe that explains. seems we're doing fine with everything. I hope Brett will now decently pick up. That would be nice. There we go. We unlocked Curator. With that you get 10% attractiveness extra. So we get more income from the pier. Cannot ship in stuff here and then sell it again. That's not very smart. So I fixed it. Bread is finally picking up. That's good. And you see, we took another bonus, the cushioner or something. Attractiveness plus 20%. You see, it still has to populate. Only because of the festivity. I don't think we want a pier for that. Bread keeps trickling in, very nice. I think we have enough jungle items, but I'm or animals, but I'm not sure. Yeah, we need 500 more tourists at the moment. Thank you. We're almost full. We're full already. So I need another 750 tourists at the moment. I did buy a lot, didn't I? Let's stop buying for a second. Okay, so now everything is finally here in tourists. You can see that in my income. I don't know. Oh, 100%, really? Then I can't compare decently. Okay, that's annoying. That's annoying. Brett still did not finalize. Like, still filling up. I just remember I also didn't watch the prices of the last buys I did at the trader. Oh, that takes a half hour, really? I don't have time for that. I on purpose went for a longer episode so I could show the whole tier in one go, because that makes it more clear what you're doing. And then a festival hits, of course, a festival of 30 minutes. So it's doubled now. So normally it would make 2300, so I make 10,000 normally. So you see, with now my artisans, excuse me, with artisans up and the museum filled and the zoo filled, I make a 10,000 income. And from there I will continue. So we had 5,000 from the workers, and now we do 10,000 with artisans. Thank you for watching. I hope you picked something up. Let's close it down. Oh, I wanted to tell you, you see I have everywhere piers now and cannon towers. I did that on all islands, so all islands have efficient logistics and defense up. I didn't defend all sides like in an expert game, but I will do that in the next episode. Have a nice day. Thank you for watching. Bye.